Hello and good evening. It's that time of the week and time of the day again. And I want to take a few moments while I still have warm blood and warm air flowing through my lungs and my tongue, and I can still speak. I want to take a moment to send a special congratulations to my hero and my dear friend, Vladimir Putin, the Commandante Zero, and if you could say the Supreme Leader of Mother Russia. I want to congratulate Putin for taking the opportune moment to defend Mother Russia, to defend her territorial integrity and her status and her position in the world. For many of you who do not understand what is happening in the world, the fact that the Western nations want to encroach the entire humanity. They want to bring democracy to China. They want to bring democracy to North Korea. And they want to bring democracy to Russia. What does that mean? It means they want to overthrow the establishment. Oh, they also want to do it in Iran. They have did it in Iraq. They did it in Syria. They did it in Libya. They did it in Egypt, just to turn back and put a military dictator back in power. But one thing I can say about President Putin that I'm very, very proud of is that he's strong, he's determined, he's not afraid. He was not afraid to act in Syria. And now he's not afraid to let the West and to let NATO know and to let the world know he means business. And when Putin say that he has placed his tactical nuclear force on alert, you have to take him serious at that. And if need be, that he has to use tactical and Russia adopts a first use doctrine that they will use nuclear weapons first before the enemy uses it. That's powerful. So today I want to congratulate Prime Minister Putin, President Putin, for being able to cripple Ukraine, to halt the eastward expansion of NATO, and to show that he means business, and that Russia will not be conquered, Russia will not be subjugated, and Mother Russia will not be what we call in the Western culture today, canceled. You cannot cancel Russia, you cannot cancel Russian influence, and you cannot cancel Russian history. Those of you who don't know what's going on, and who only took note on March 2nd, when we begin to hit the Ukrainians with rockets, and all of the propaganda telling you, oh, Putin is going to conquer Ukraine in 3 days. It's only the United States who said they were going to go and conquer Iraq in a day with shock and awe. Russia never intended to have shock and awe. Nor Russia never intended to totally devastate and to destroy Ukraine. And if Russia wants to do that, they can do that at will. But anyway, congratulations to my comrade, to my hero, to my president. I love strong leaders. I love them. Leaders who are not afraid to fight and to stand up for what they believe in and to stand up to the enemy. And so on the month of this struggle, we know that it's going to be a very long and protracted war. And in the end, Russia will win. Russia has always won when it comes to protracted war. Russia won when Napoleon came. Russia won when Hitler came. And today, Russia is going to win when Sleepy Joe Biden and homosexual Obama attempted with their eastward expansion of NATO and to encircle Russia and to cancel Russia and to destroy Mother Russia. Long live Mother Russia. This one is for Mother Russia. Long live Putin. Long live Putin. Victory to Mother Russia. You know, most of us in the United States of America have been brainwashed by the Europeans, and we think home ownership and subdivision living means that we must grow grass all of our lives and water grass, while people around us do not have arable drinking water. Even in Flint, Michigan, even in Mississippi, even in certain parts of Texas. And for 24 years, I've had this fertile soil back here. And I must admit that I have been brainwashed and I have been cowed. And for all these years, I've been growing grass and growing grass. And finally, this year, I've decided to transform this piece of land, this backyard. It don't look like a lot to you, but it's a lot, especially when you have to dig the grass out one shovel at a time. And that's what I'm doing. An European would go and rent a tiller, would tear up the hell out of the grass, tear up the sprinkler system in the process. But I'm doing it one shovel at a time, and I'm going to get it done by this weekend, and this is going to be our garden. Why is it important for us to transform all this grass into a food growing area? Because for those of you who are not aware and who do not know, Russia and Ukraine are the largest producers of grain and wheat in the world. And there's going to be a shortage of wheat and a shortage of grain and a shortage of food. So it's important that if you have the means to provide sustenance, to provide sustainability, to grow your own food, that you do so. As you can see here, these are many of my garlic plants that we surround the house with to protect from evil. But we're going to carve out this entire plot right here. And we're going to grow bananas, we're going to grow dashin, we're going to grow tanya, we're going to grow wheat, we're going to grow sweet and sour potatoes, we're going to grow every type of vegetable and crop that we'll need to survive. And eventually we're going to dig a hole, a deep hole, and we're going to have a chicken pen, and we're going to have a pig pen. Somewhere around here we're going to put a pig pen where we can grow a pig for slaughter, because pigs can grow in a finite space and do well. And then we'll be able to eat it when the time comes. Eventually, we'll try to replace the fence so we can protect ourselves from these nosy neighbors who all they want is to come after us for trying to live like free men. They think that freedom is only for them and not for us. They still think we are only 3/5 of a person. But if you're out there and you hear this message, I want you to know that time is of the essence. This war with Russia is not going to end anytime soon, because Russia has to push on. Russia has to make a point. Russia has to defend Mother Russia and protect it from being canceled by the West. And we do not have any objection to Russia's struggle. We are not here to fight Russia. We are here to have freedom. And the only people, you know, everybody in the world is fighting for dignity. The Chinese are fighting to avenge 100 years of humiliation from the Western powers and from Japan. The Russians are fighting to restore the dignity of Mother Russia. The only people in the world that are not fighting to restore their dignity are the Negro peoples, the African peoples, and the so-called niggers of the world. Let me say it again. Only Negroes, only the so-called Negroes and the Africans and the niggers are the ones who are not fighting to regain dignity and humanity in this world. Everybody else is on the move. And then when you hear the Negro, he start crying. You're crying for the child in Ukraine. You're crying for the Ukrainians. You ever see anybody cry for Ethiopia? You ever seen anybody cry for the Congo? You ever seen anybody cry for Angola? You ever seen anybody cry for Somalia? You ever seen anybody cry for Liberia and for Sierra Leone in the hashes of times? Ask yourself those questions before you listen to that propaganda. Anyway, it's dinner time now. And dinner is very light. A small piece of chicken, a small piece of potato, some broccoli. What I want to show you, a sip of wine and a cigar. And what I wanted to show you most of all is my packages of seeds that I have purchased. Okay, cucumbers, corn. Everywhere is only sweet corn, so I have to find another variety of corn. Sunflower seeds, cantaloupe, kale, cantaloupe, cilantro. For some reason, my cilantro never came back. It used to come back every year. Asparagus, carrots, spinach, green peas. And as you know, the fruit themselves, dill. So all this is going to be growing back here in this yard. And I'm going to order some banana plants. Again, I ordered a couple. I got them too early. But some fruit-bearing bananas. If they make it, they make it. If they don't, but we're going to keep trying. Some citrus plants. And this entire region is going to be changed, converted from a place where we grow grass. For how many years I've struggled, I've picked weeds, I've fertilized, paid an undocumented worker. Now the HOA want to tell you that you must cut your grass weekly. So you must employ an undocumented worker every week and break federal law so your grass can look nice and green and keep a certain height. Well, I say to you today, as my life is upon it, as I bet on Russia and I bet on Putin, that this here grass is going to go, and it's going to go forever. And it's going to be replaced with food in the backyard and on the side of the house. And eventually we're going to the front yard. We're going to rip up that grass, and we'd rather grow stones than grass. So if we got to grow stones, we'll grow stones. But we're not going to be watering grass anymore just for the sake of having green grass and having neighbors call on us during the drought period. People hiding to water their grass so the grass can look green because there is a water shortage, and the city will fine you if they catch you watering. So tonight I want to tell you I'm well, I'm alive. The struggle continues, the luta continua. And we're going to double down. We're going to double down on trouble. We're going to double down. We're going to take a play from President Putin. We're going to go on the offensive against our enemies. God bless President Putin. God bless Russia. And all who wish for the death of President Putin will die before him. Because Putin, the only good thing Yeltsin did before he died, was anointed the right person to lead Russia, the right person to bring back the greatness of Russia, the right Tsar, Tsar Vladimir Putin. May he rule for 1,000 years. And all of you who say ill things about him, may all the illness you say towards him and about him be turned around and come up against you. God bless Putin. God bless the United States. And God bless Peter Emmanuel, the only one who is fighting for the dignity of the Negro. The Negro know nothing about fighting for the dignity that have been stripped from them by the Europeans for the last 1,000 years. Among the peoples of the world, the so-called Negro, or what you all call the nigger, or the Africans are the only people who are not fighting to restore their honor and their dignity. The Chinese people, after over 100 years of humiliation at the feet of the Europeans, are today have been undergone a renaissance. And China is one of the most powerful countries on earth today, with the largest economy, and one of the most powerful military, with even more advanced weapons than the United States of America itself. The United States of America and Northern Europe thought they used to monopolize knowledge and monopolize power. And they made a deal with the heaven and with the God. In exchange for cheap labor, they gave the technology to the Chinese communists. The Chinese communists mastered it, perfected it, and made it even better. After Ukraine comes Taiwan, because Taiwan is an integral part of China, and Taiwan is a province of China. And China must support Russia, because in order for China to invade Taiwan, China will need the cover and the support of Russia. So what you see happening today is just a dry run. It's no different than going back to the first half of the 20th century, when we had the powers of the great nations of Europe, the colonialists, aligned against the Japanese, who said Asia is our sphere of influence. And they fought bitterly to prove that. And they almost came close to winning, so they made Japan a Western nation. Then we have North and South Korea. And we have everywhere in the world that the West wants to impose and to put a government in place that is pro-Western, that will allow the West to exploit their resources in return for nothing. This is happening in South America. It happened in Venezuela. It happened in Ecuador, where even Elon Musk took part in a coup d'etat. Because Elon Musk wants the minerals that's plentiful in Ecuador that he uses in the battery for his electronic vehicles. So today, Mother Russia has once again, they have awakened the sleeping bear, this giant bear of the East, whom had been in a sleep and slumber and had been humiliated in the demise and the destruction of the Soviet Empire. But Putin repeatedly told the West, don't go too far. Don't go too far. George Bush looked into Putin's eyes, and what he saw was a strong and determined leader. Biden looked into Putin's eyes and he was scared. And Putin told Biden this was coming. They knew it was coming. They're trying to pretend that Russia just suddenly invaded Ukraine. No. Russia warned them. Russia asked them for detente. Russia asked them to have an agreement. They refused. So Russia says, well, guess what? We're going to show you. And Russia is showing them now. And I just showed you in earlier sessions, we're digging out the grass. We're going to dig a hole to grow chickens. We're going to dig a hole to grow a pig. We can't grow cattle. We need land to grow cattle. And we've got our seeds, and we're going to get more seeds. And if I were you, I would collect seeds, as many types of seeds as you can, watermelons, cantaloupe, okra. Okra is a good one. It grows, it bears very frequently. Cabbages, you name it. This summer, this year, we are into food production, and we're going to cultivate the backyard and the front yard, and we're going to let them come and tell us we cannot do it, because we have a right to be a free man. That's what we're told. Finally, we are free. And we have a right to grow food. We have a right. That's a fundamental human right, the right to grow food. So wherever you are, and I want you to get up off your lazy Negro ass and go and put something in the soil. Don't wait for that ship to come to bring your codfish, to bring your smoked herring, or your pig snout, or your salted pork. Go and grow something so that you can have food independence, food reliance, self-reliance, that you can survive when this thing hits full blast. It's not over. It's just getting started. Okay, NATO is scared. NATO is scared. If NATO had the muscle they had, they would have sent troops, they would have sent fighter jets to try to checkmate Putin. But Putin knows better. The beer has been awakened. That beer was in what is it, hibernation? He's been in hibernation for 20-some years. 20-some years of hibernating. And now the Russian beer has awakened. The beer has awakened. God help us all. But anyway, Mother Russia has never done anything to hurt us. Mother Russia never hurt me. Mother Russia never called me a nigger. Northern Russia never tried to take my house from me.